A bogus tip to police leads them to three robbery suspects.
Those three people are in the Tulsa County Jail right now, and that's where we find News on 6's Aaron Conrad live on the story. Aaron.
Well, Terry and Craig, it sounds like a cheesy line and a joke, but what do a bank robbery, a bogus kidnapping tip, and a purse snatching all have in common? Well, the only thing is it led to more arrests than Tulsa police anticipated today. Tulsa police had their hands full today as they investigated active crimes happening all over the city in a matter of moments.
It was a perfect storm for what happened today.
Tulsa police chased this red car into a neighborhood off 41st Street after the passengers were acting suspicious near Promenade Mall. The three people inside ditched the car in this driveway and ran off. But what police found had nothing to do with what they thought they were investigating.
They gave chase thinking they were after someone who had just taken some children, when in actuality, what they were chasing was the suspects from the Walgreens purse snatching.
They arrested Garlanda Boyles, Corian Campbell, and Boyles' 16-year-old son. Police say the teen punched a woman in the face multiple times at this Walgreens and stole her purse, while the other two waited in the getaway car.
Once that was all concluded and they had everyone in custody, we found out there was no abduction, and that was a bogus call.
That bogus call was a tip to distract police from a bank robbery at 36 and Yale. Police say those suspects called in the bogus tip about the child abduction to distract police, but ended up leading officers to the suspects in the Walgreens robbery. Well, now what it all boils down to, police tell me, is that even with all of this chaos today, they still managed to debunk a bogus tip and make arrests in both the bank robbery and the Walgreens strong-armed robbery. For now, we're live on the scene on the story in Tulsa. Aaron Conrad, News on 6.